So good morning students, welcome to English class. We are in the lesson The Boy Who Broke the Bag. In the previous class we learned that the news spread all over the town and the people were speculating and guessing the reason for the collapse of the bank, and they concluded that the reason was that Seth was a pleasure loving person and he was not a hard working man. So these are some different guesswork that the people made the reason for the collapse of the bank. Now let us recall, what did the elderly gentleman conclude about the bank? The elderly gentleman concluded that definitely the bank was about to collapse. What message did he convey about the owner of the bank? He conveyed that the owner of the bank had left the town. Who were the other persons came to know about the news? The pan seller, the tailor, the fruit vendor, the jeweler and the beggar sitting on the pavement were the other persons came to know about the news. Why some people congratulated themselves? Some people congratulated themselves because they had already taken out their money. And some had never put any money in the bank. What was the conclusion made by the people of the town? The people concluded that Seth Govindram was a pleasure loving person and he was not a hard working man. And they concluded that he had fled the country, and some said that he had fled the state, and some other told that he was hiding somewhere in the town. Someone who had a relative working as a clerk in the bank decided to call him and get the facts. "I don't know anything about it," said the clerk, "except the half town is here trying to take their money out. Everyone seems to have gone mad. There's a rumor that none of you has been paid." So there was a person whose relative was working in a bank, and so they called him to know about the exact situation. And so the clerk is also not able to understand what is happening, why people are going so mad right now. And he told that they all are coming to withdraw their money. So this person asked the clerk whether he has been paid this month. "Well, the clerks have had their salaries. They wouldn't be working otherwise. It may be that some of the part-time workers are getting paid late, but that isn't due to shortage of money. It's just that the clerk who looks after their payments is on sick leave. You don't expect me to do his work, do you?" And he put the telephone down. So this clerk tells the person that they had already received their salary, but it is possible that some of the workers might not have got it because the person who is looking after the payments of these workers is on a sick leave. So saying this, he just put the telephone down. By afternoon, the bank had gone through all its ready money, and the harassed bank manager was helpless. Emergency funds could only be obtained from one of the government banks, and now it was nearly closing time. The clerks shut down their counters, but people gathered outside on the steps of the bank shouting, "We want our money. Give it to us today or we'll break in. Fetch Seth Govindram. We know he is hiding in the vaults." So the bank had tried to get all the money they could and had started giving out the money to the people who had come to the bank. But they could not raise so much of money to pay all the people immediately. And soon it was time for the bank to be closed. All the workers were there. They started closing their counters because it was time to leave. But people outside were furious and they were shouting that they want their money immediately. and they were also telling that the owner was hiding in the vaults. Vaults means rooms with thick walls and strong doors where money and other precious items are kept to prevent them from being stolen. Now mischief makers who did not have a paisa in the bank joined the crowd. The manager stood at the door and tried to calm his angry customers. He declared that the bank had plenty of money, that they could withdraw all they wanted the next morning. "We want it now," chanted the people. "Now, now, now." So even the mischief makers who do not have a paisa in the bank joined the crowd and were shouting. The manager stood at the door and tried to calm them, that the bank had plenty of money, but they could withdraw their money the next morning. But the people did not hear to him, and again they shouted. A few stones were thrown and the manager retreated indoors, closing the iron grill gate. A brick hurtled through the air and smashed into the plate glass window, which advertised the bank's asset. So the crowd was getting violent and the people started throwing stones and bricks at the bank. So because of this, the manager had to retreat indoors and he closed the iron grill gate of the bank. So at that time, a brick hurtled means the stone flew at great speed through the air, and it smashed the plate glass window where the bank had advertised its assets. So ready money means money in the form of cash that a bank has available for transactions. Harassed means tired and anxious. Walls, rooms with thick walls and strong doors where money and other precious items are kept to prevent them from being stolen. Hurtled, a flew at great speed. So let us recall, why did the clerk at the bank think everyone had gone mad? The clerk thought that everyone had gone mad because all the people were coming to the bank to take back the money, and they had crowded outside. How did the clerk from the bank clarify the situation? The clerk said that he has been paid that month, but it is possible that some of the workers might not have gotten, because the person who is looking after the payment of these workers is on a sick leave. Why was the bank manager helpless? The bank manager was helpless because the bank had gone through all its ready money and he could not meet the needs of the people who had gathered outside. What were the commotions happened outside the bank? The people who had gathered outside, they shouted that they wanted the money that day itself, or they will break in the bank. And some of the mischief makers also joined the crowd. Even they do not have a paisa in the bank. How did the bank manager convince the people outside? The bank manager told that the bank had plenty of money and they could withdraw all they wanted the next morning. Did the bank manager succeed in convincing the people? No, the bank manager did not succeed, and the people did not hear to him, and they started throwing stones at the manager. So homework, read para 22 to 28 and write the meanings of the words in a fair note. So harassed, chanted, hurtled, walls. Also write the answers for the recall questions in your rough note. Write the answers for the recall question in your rough note. Thank you, students.